internet. Today I'm here to do my summer book haul. So these are all of the books I bought in the months of June, July, and August. And I bought a lot. I have 22 books to show you today. Oops. So let's just get into it so that way this video isn't 10 years long. So the very first book I have to haul today is Save the Date by Morgan Matson. This is her newest contemporary. I believe it follows a girl who's, I want to say sister, is getting married, and it kind of becomes like a crazy family affair. I want to say that the wedding's going to be at their house or something, so things get kind of crazy, and I think it takes place over the weekend of the wedding. I always love reading Morgan Matson's books. They're always just super duper cute, and I've heard pretty good things about this one, so I'm looking forward to jumping into it. Also, it's adorable. I always love the covers of her books. Look at that puppy. The next book I have is Puddin' by Julie Murphy. This is the sequel to Dumplin', and this follows a different character. It follows Millie from Dumplin'. I have not read this one yet either, but I'm really looking forward to it. And other than that, I don't know a whole lot about the plot, but I'm really excited to read it because I absolutely loved Dumplin'. And I also bought this because I was getting ready to go to a book signing, so I got it signed, and I'm pretty excited. And Julie signed it, Riots Not Diets Baby, and I love it. But I have not read this yet, so I gotta get on that. Next, I have The Lies About Truth by Courtney C. Stevens. I'm gonna be honest, I just bought this because it was Courtney Stevens, and I have no idea what it's about. It's another YA contemporary, but I love Courtney Stevens, so I bought it because I found it at a used bookstore for cheap, and I hadn't read it. That's why. I still haven't read it yet. I'm working on it. Next, I have Labyrinth Lost by Zoraida Cordova. This is a YA fantasy about a girl, or a bruja, who really doesn't want her powers, so she decides to perform this spell that is supposed to get rid of her powers, and her entire family ends up disappearing, and she has to go and find them. I enjoyed this read when I read it. I read it back in July, I think. But I bought it because, again, I was getting ready to go to a book signing. So basically, in June, there was a book signing for, it was the Bells and Brujas tour, so it was Zoraida Cordova and Danielle Clayton, but at the Nashville stop, Julie Murphy and Victoria Schwab were also there. So it was a good time. But I bought this in anticipation of that as well. So I got it signed, and it says Make Magic. But I enjoyed this book. If you want to know my thoughts, you can check out my wrap-ups. I'm pretty sure I read it in July because I think I read it for Biennial Billy Avon. And now along the same lines for the book signing, this is when I actually, you know, got there, and so I had to buy more books, of course. So I bought the new cover for Vicious by V.E. Schwab, which is one of my faves. It's one of my favorite books I've read this year, and I had to get the gorgeous new edition that came out because when Vengeful comes out, which is the sequel, and it comes out at the end of this month, it needed to match. So I bought it, and I got it signed. It says, leave your mark. But yes, if you haven't read Vicious yet, you need to get on that because it's amazing. And last book from that particular book signing, we have The Bells by Danielle Clayton. And this is a YA fantasy about a world where there are these girls called the Bells who basically have the ability to make people pretty, I guess, in a sense, or at least their world's version of pretty. And our main character is gotten the honor to be the belle for the royal family. I read this in June. I think I read it like as I got it. I listened to the audiobook, and I did enjoy it. I'm looking forward to the sequel. It was very different, but if you want to know my thoughts again, check out my June wrap-up. But of course, I got this one signed as well. It says, May you always find beauty. And I think that this is a gorgeous cover as well, so I'm glad to have this in my collection, and the spine is so beautiful. It's just a very pretty book. So, next, I have the book that came in the June Owl Crate, which was From Twinkle With Love by Sendai Manon. And I have read this one as well. It's about a girl named Twinkle who wants to be a filmmaker, and she has a crush on this boy in school. And she has pretty much forever had a crush on him. And she gets the opportunity to create a film for this like local film festival, and her crush's twin is actually going to be producing it with her, and she may start having feelings for him instead. For thoughts on this book, you can check out my August wrap-up, because I read it then. It was okay. It wasn't my favorite contemporary in the world, but I do highly recommend it. Most people seem to really, really love this one, so I definitely recommend it. It just wasn't necessarily my taste. And I'm glad that I have the special Owlcrate exclusive edition as well. Moving on. So in July, Amazon had their Prime Day sale, which is when like a bunch of stuff on Amazon is super cheap. And of course, if you have Amazon Prime, you get free shipping. So I got a couple of books. I got the first two books in the Magnus Chase series by Rick Riordan. So we have The Sword of Summer and we have The Hammer of Thor, because these were both part of that Prime Day sale, so they were super cheap. And I've been wanting to start a new Rick Riordan series soon, and I've heard really, really good things about this one, so I thought I'd go ahead and pick up the first two books since they were cheap, so that way whenever I'm ready to dive into some Rick Riordan, I got some to dig into. But this is a series that has to do with Norse mythology, and other than that, I really don't know what happens. I think it's just a trilogy, which I say just a trilogy, but I think that the entire series is out now. I'm just waiting for the third book to come out in paperback before I buy it as well. So, yes, I'm really looking forward to diving into this one because I've heard really, really good things about it. Next, I have The Miseducation of Cameron Post by Emily M. Danforth. This is a YA contemporary about a girl named Cameron Post who I believe, this takes place in like the 70s or 80s, I think. And I believe her parents die in a car crash and she goes to live with her grandmother or her aunt or something. And then when they find out that she's gay, they send her to, cannot think of the term right now, but it's one of those like camps where they fix you or whatever. They fix your sexuality. I have not read it yet, obviously. I bought it because I really wanted to read it and then go see the movie. The movie really is hard to find in theaters, so I may have to wait till it comes out on DVD, which kind of sucks. But I haven't had time to read the book anyway. But I've heard really good things about it. I went ahead and just bought the movie cover because that was the only one I could find in the store. And I just really wanted to buy this book, so I did it, and I like the movie cover okay. It's not too bad. Typically, I don't buy the books with movie covers, but I don't mind this one so much. And I'm hoping to read it very soon and maybe finally be able to go see the movie. I also have The Traitor Prince by CJ Redwine. And this is the third book in her Ravenspire series, which is basically a companion series of fairy tale retellings. I cannot remember what fairy tale this one is based off of. It wasn't one of the more common ones, best I remember. So I don't remember it. Maybe The Prince and the Pauper. I can't really remember. But the first two books in this series, The Shadow Queen, which is the first one, is a Snow White retelling, and the second one, The Wish Granter, is a Rumpelstiltskin retelling, and they were both amazing, super dark. I really love them, so I definitely want to start this one soon because I know it's going to be just as good as the other two. The next few books are from when I went to McKay's, which is a local used bookstore here in Nashville that I love, which you'll know if you watch my videos. And I bought a bunch of books there one day because I sold some things, so I had some credit to spend, so I spent it. The first one is super, like, random for me. It's not my usual thing at all, but it is something I'm interested in. And that is 11/22/63 by Stephen King. So I want to try and read some Stephen King books, but I don't like horror, which is kind of his main thing. So I thought this one would be a good one to pick up, and I've heard that it's good. I believe it's about a guy who goes back in time to try and stop the assassination of JFK, which sounds super interesting. It's ginormous. So I might save it for like a Tome Chocolate readathon or something, but you know, I found it at McKay's and it was cheap and I decided to go ahead and pick it up. The only other Stephen King book I read is the first book in the Dark Tower series. So if you have any recommendations for Stephen King books that are not scary, let me know. While I was at McKay's, I also got The Invasion of the Tierling and The Fate of the Tierling by Erica Johansson. This is the second and third book in this trilogy. Is it called the Queen of the Tierling trilogy? I'm not really sure what this trilogy is called, and it doesn't say. But these. The Queen of the Tierling is on my list of books I have to read this year. And since McKay's had the hardcover editions and the rest of the series, I just went ahead and picked them up because I feel like I'm going to like The Queen of the Tierling, and that way I can just read the whole thing. I also got With Malice by Eileen Cook. This is a YA thriller, and that's all I know. You know, you don't typically want to know a whole lot about thrillers before you go into them, so I don't know a whole lot about this one. But I've heard that it's good, and when I went, I was in kind of that mood, so I picked it up. I also have Please Ignore Vera Dietz by A.S. King. I basically got this because I've never read anything by A.S. King, and I've heard that she's a really incredible author, but I don't know a whole lot, really anything, honestly, about the plot other than it's magical realism, because that's A.S. King's thing, is she writes magical realism. But I mean, it's a Pulitzer Prize honor book, so that means it must be pretty good. Next, I have a couple of books from Book Depository, which is a website where you can order books and they ship free worldwide, and they have UK books as well. So usually that's my go-to for if I need a book in the UK edition. So I have A Conjuring of Light by V.E. Schwab, which is the third book in the Shades of Magic trilogy, which is one of my favorite series of all time. And I have the UK editions as well, because my first copy that I read of A Darker Shade of Magic I actually bought while I was in London. So this is the only one I didn't have in the UK edition, so I went ahead and ordered it because there was another book that I needed to order from there anyway, so I picked this one up as well. And that other book that I had to order was Harry Potter and the Chamber of Secrets by J.K. Rowling. This is the Gryffindor House Edition, the 20th anniversary edition with the spray-painted edges and just the beautifulness. I have the Sorcerer's Stone as well. They're coming out pretty much with one every year. I didn't actually know that they were going to do all of the books, but it appears that they are. So I will own all of them as they come out. We are almost done. So I went to another book signing in August because City of Ghosts by Victoria Schwab came out, and of course the launch party was at Parnassus, so I had to go. And I haven't read this yet. I'm hoping to read it next month, in October, because I feel like it'll be a good spooky book. But this is a middle grade, about a girl named Cassidy, who I believe is a ghost hunter. And she had a near-death experience, so she is kind of considered to be on the in-between. Like, she's alive, but she's not fully alive. And her family hunts ghosts, and they actually have, like, a reality show or something. So they end up going to Scotland for a little bit. And I believe that Cassidy comes, I believe she meets a ghost boy. And they end up trying to do something together, solve some kind of mystery or something. I've heard that it's really, really good. I'm really excited to read it. Like I said, I want to read it in October because I feel like it'll be a good Halloween book. But I'm really excited that Victoria Schwab has a new book. She's my favorite author. Speaking of Victoria Schwab, I also picked up The Dark Vault, which has her two books in the Archived series, but it has The Archived and The Unbound. And then there's a short story at the end of The Unbound that I think is supposed to kind of wrap things up a little bit, because Victoria Schwab was never able to publish the third book in this series, unfortunately. So that's why I wanted to buy it in this edition, so that way I could kind of get that wrap up. But I've heard that these are really good. This is a YA series of hers. And so I'm excited to have this. And this edition just came out, so it's very, very pretty. Two more books. So next I have The Seven Husbands of Evelyn Hugo by Taylor Jenkins Reid. This book has been all over BookTube recently, and pretty much everybody has said great things about it. I'm really, really looking forward to reading it. This is about Evelyn Hugo's life, basically. I think she's telling her life to a reporter, and it's supposed to be amazing. And I've got the audiobook on hold at my library. I'm just waiting until it comes to me. But I'm really, really looking forward to reading this, and I'm hoping to read it very, very soon. And the very last book I have to haul today is the August Outcrate book, and that is Grace and Fury by Tracy Banghart. I don't remember a whole lot about the plot other than it's about two sisters and, like, magic and I'm royalty and stuff. I don't remember the plot much at all. I'd look it up, but I just saw the time and I need to leave for work in a minute, so I need to wrap this up. But this is the Outcrate exclusive edition. It's absolutely gorgeous, and I've heard pretty good things about it so far, so I'm looking forward to reading it. So that is my summer book haul. Good lord, that was exhausting. Let me know down in the comments as far as the books that I have not read yet, which ones I should read first. And I will see you guys next time with another video.